सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। आई वेलकम यू ऑल विथ माई लव एंड रेस्पेक्ट्स। आई वेलकम ऑल द डिवोटीज डिसाइपल्स who are sitting with us around the world at this moment in 210 places, in 75 cities, in 18 countries. And 15 cities are two-way with us. Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Ohio, Phoenix, Malaysia, Guadeloupe, Singapore, Hyderabad, Golden Enclave, Annanagar, Adyar, Salem, Morocco, Brazil. All these countries are in two-way with us. I welcome all of you. So before entering into the NFACT, I want to remind all of you to sit in Padmasana and Samana Mudra, we can start the NFACT. Today's sutra Gaunaschet Natma Sabdat. Again, just two word. Translation of Gambhirananda says, if it be argued that the seeing is in a secondary sense, we say not so, owing to the use of the word self. Translation of Swami Vireshwarananda says, if it be said that thinking is used in a secondary sense, we say not so, because of the word self, by which the first cause is referred to in scriptures. This is one of the deepest philosophical problem, but which is responsible for our very way of thinking. There can be argument. See, this is actually a continuation of yesterday's sutra. Yesterday, the Brahma Sutra's essence is source of you, source of the universe is independent intelligence, not a dead matter or a dead law. You need to understand. The source of existence is not dead matter. It is you. The source of universe, which is you, is life. It is independent intelligence, living mechanism. This truth is established through a logic, because all experiences are happening in you, which is a living self. The source is living self. Please understand, only when you know the source is living intelligence, you will be honest In every step you take in your life, you will be honest. One of the biggest problem I find in the so-called spiritual seekers is when they lose trust over the law of the land and law of the society, they lose integrity. Understand, losing integrity is not spirituality. Just because you lost respect, usually the seekers tend to lose respect for the law of the land or law of the society. Because when you are a seeker, you evolve to a certain level, your hypocrisy goes away. When your hypocrisy goes away, the hypocritical laws of the society and the law of the land loses its power over you. You just realize social laws are nothing but social hypocrisy. Usually the law of land is exploited by the people who are in power. When somebody realizes this truth, they tend to lose respect for the social laws and social rules and country laws, law of the land. But unfortunately, when you lose respect for law of land, you become hypocritical. The integrity is lost. The honesty is lost. Understand? For an ultimate enlightened being and for a terrorist, for both the social law and country law does not bind, but an enlightened being retains his integrity. A terrorist does not have integrity. I can say many seekers lose their integrity, almost become terrorists. When you lose respect for the social law and country law, you are supposed to have the deep respect and the true experience and at least an unshakable cognitive factual clarity that existence is intelligence, everything goes as per the justice of the intelligence. If you have that one clarity, you will not become terrorists. You will not become terrorists. If you have the one clarity, understand, an ordinary man is a man who is bound by the social law and law of the land. An enlightened being is a person who is not bound by these two laws, but he has a clarity of the cosmic law. It is intelligence which is doing everything, so he rests in peace. He will be deeply compassionate and non-violent. He will have the complete restful awareness and peace. He is an enlightened being. Then there is another one classification. Person who does not have respect for social law and law of the land, but do not have the cognitive factual clarification, the whole is independent, intelligent. He thinks the whole is just dead matter. So anybody can do injustice to himself or his group. Then naturally what he thinks, come on, let me take a weapon in my hand, and take revenge by myself. That is where the deviation happens. That is a road where an enlightened master takes a path, different path, and a terrorist takes a different path. Otherwise, till that point, both travel together. Whether you are going to become an enlightened being or a terrorist is going to be defined just on this one sutra. The seekers who do not have integrity, I am afraid of them. Not bother to do anything. Sometime you will see the people who come here and pose as seekers. I'll try to get rid of them as quickly as possible, because these fellows have lost respect for the law of the land and law of the society, but they do not have the integrity. The cosmos is intelligence. The existence is from intelligence. It's a very dangerous thing. That is why again and again and again masters insist on receiving the truths completely. If you just miss this one point, think the cosmos is matter, you will become a violent terrorist. Because they think the cosmos is not intelligence. Violent terrorists all have a complete underground belief. The basis of life is a dead matter. Anybody who can bully is successful man. No. That's a completely wrong basis. There is an argument by the materialists and different groups saying, no, no. Just because we are seeing, we are thinking, we cannot say our source is consciousness. It may be secondary sense. Brahma Sutra breaks that argument, saying no. If it is secondary, then the first person should not be able to perceive it. The perception itself is done in consciousness.